It was just the kind of thing I love to see, and I've always wanted to be in. So it was a kind of surefire winner. The character was at that stage sort of not quite as fully developed as she is now. But I went and met the director, who'd sort of, and as soon as I saw what he wanted to do with it, I was kind of intrigued. He was just very challenging. He kind of wanted this alpha female, which he kind of got in the end. But he was very adamant that he wanted, you know, this idea of a female boss. He was kind of turned on to that, and the idea of what would happen if an alpha female met an alpha male, and the way that sort of, you know, would sort of create sexual chemistry. It was great. I mean, I've been a fan for a long time, since The Believer, and of course The Notebook. I just think, you know, who is this person? He's kind of got this sort of endearing arrogance to him, really. And it's a sort of arrogance that you sort of don't want to like, and then you end up falling for it. And he does it again, kind of with this character, Willie. You know, at first, Willie starts off as someone who sort of endorses everything. You sort of might have a prejudice about lawyers. You know, he kind of is arrogant, he's self-centred, he sort of doesn't have much time for people. And then he kind of gets morality through this film, really. But he questions everything, Ryan. He's a very playful actor, and he's funny. He's not kind of too serious, like everybody assumes. LA, I find a sort of city. I mean, for me, it's a complete city of sort of movie making and fantasy, and I want to keep it that way. I never want to live there, because as long as I don't live there, it stays like a sort of playground of sort of dreams, and you can be anyone and be and try anything, and it sort of has this wonderful freedom to it. In the film, it's almost a character, because Greg and Kramer, the cinematographer, have shot it in such a way that it's sort of, it's all these reflective surfaces, this very kind of slick world where everything kind of has a reflection. There are sort of two ways of looking at everything. You know, the lift doors are shiny, the floors are shiny, there are sort of even reflections in blood, you see, in car sides, sides of cars, people's sunglasses. I think it's a very, very clever way of looking at it, this city of bright sun and multiple dimension. Well, I think what Working Title are doing are brilliant. Unfortunately, you know, we've only got one real major sort of studio, really. There are great stories coming out of Britain. It's just that I think one of our problems is that we share a language with America. I think if we were French, like the French can make very, very good French films. They're a big success in France, and that's fine. A couple of them every year go to the kind of global market. But if they're a success in France, that's great. Whereas here, we can't just make a film to be a success in England. It has to be a sort of success in America as well. And I think that sort of penalises in some way, because, you know, there are stories that are essentially British that otherwise would get made and don't.